We're officially going to compare the mini planner to the traditional planner so you guys can see the differences. Sometimes I can't explain exactly because some things are just sizing, so I'm gonna show you guys. This planner also comes in these different cover options. So we have the French blue, we have blush from our very first launch, we have the pink watercolors, we have one which is restocked, I think third or fourth time, baby blue. Wait, is this baby blue? Yeah, baby blue. This is from last launch. And then we have the new cheetah print. And my sample's actually a little bit pinker, but it's gonna be this kind of neutral cool tone brown. These are the different cover options. They'll all have a pocket on the inside of the front cover. So let's look at the mini first. I wanna show the dividers because this is a question I get a lot. I did shrink the font because I wanted the font a little bit smaller. Again, this is a sample that didn't make the cut and I'll show you guys why, but one of the things I asked them to change was the size of the letters on here. And obviously they'll be centered for you, but you can just simply take them out. They're kind of their own thing. They are paper, so if you don't like them, you can swap them out. But if you like them, they come with the planner. They'll have everything kind of set up for you. You can also add your own on top of these, but they're kind of set up for you, ready to go. I wanted them to be very similar to the dividers that we have in the traditional planner. Now, I'm gonna try really hard to do kind of a side-by-side. So we have the yearly planning with two pages, and then you have the boxed yearly instead of the day by day. You then go to the vision board. It matches the same as the big planner. Then you get the annual sinking funds, same as our traditional planner. It looks, so let me show you guys how some things are a little different. So this is the regular planner and then this is the mini. So a few things, let's see. Yeah, no, it's just shrunk. I mean, you have a few different things like this. But yeah, it's nothing like super drastic different. The changes are so small, that you really don't see a huge difference. You also get the same page, bill calendar. You get the everything I owe, you get the debt trackers. The debt pay down tracker in the mini has a thermometer. I think it just has three options in the mini. It has this one, the tree and the puzzles, and the book only has the tree and the puzzles. I think that was just a design choice that I made. So you get all of those. And then you get your savings challenges. Same 52-week savings challenge, the 500, the 100 envelope challenge, savings trackers, exact same as the book. You get the pay in 4 trackers. Let me compare that to, so again, small things. So here, we put the paid off circle check. Here it's not there. Let's see, I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. It's the only difference in that one. So a few little things in the mini. It's nothing significant that you'd be like, oh, I don't want that one. I'll show you what I think is the significant part of it. You get the subscription tracker and in the big planner, let me check. Okay, so in the book, it's half page subscription tracker, half page password keeper. The mini is a full page of subscription trackers. And, oh, there we go. And then you get the medical MRA HSA. Over here, you get the same thing. It has a little gray, but the same stuff. So just small, minor things. The gifts for holiday gifts, holiday spending. You get 2 pages, let me see. The regular planner, you do not get the holiday spending tracker because it was too many sheets. So we were able to give you this in the mini, that's why it's 500 pages. And then you get 1 investment tracker, 2, and then you get 2 annual trackers. You can track more investments on here if you'd like. You get your net worth tracker. And I believe the large planner does not have that. Yeah, so the big planner doesn't have the net worth tracker. The mini one does. You get your little instructions here, and then you get month by month. See, April, May, June, July. Okay, and then you have a single page password tracker. It's the half page here. There we go. House chores. These are house cleaning schedules that you guys really wanted. You get 3 front and back note pages, and then let me jump into a month. Here in the mini, There is no scripture or faith. We've never had it in the mini because it's completely customizable. I'm debating on selling the scripture section that we created with our first planner. That's completely created by me. You can't find that on Google anywhere. I'm debating on putting that as a printable for the mini. We also gave some tips. Some of our followers have told us they get paper from Amazon that you can print that on. So that's a really good idea. Our planner in the big spiral, this is the monthly intentions, okay? So you have, the boxes are the same. You don't have a month. The mini has a month. And then you have the events and the focus. Here we have the events, and then it does a scripture. And then you have the same sinking funds update on this monthly intentions in the planner. And then the monthly layout is the same. The font and all that is the same on the month. See, this is the same. Sorry, I didn't mean to bump the camera. This is the same. Oh, the one thing, duh, is the little notes thing. So here in the book, I gave a little more fun. And then, because this one has this, I kind of wanted to make it look a little bit of a different design, but not completely. This one also has, I call this the water tracker. You can track whatever you'd like, but I put a water tracker because some people wanted a water tracker. Some people wanted a mood tracker. So I put the mood tracker in the big planner. The water tracker and the little one, but you could use this for a mood tracker as well. Lots of options there. We have the shopping list here. Just the font is different here. You have your note box the same. The habit tracker, the schedule, the bigger one gives you a separate box. And then this is the exact same. This will not be here. This is a sample that I was testing. I didn't like that. So this will be the same here. Let's hop to the back of the month. Okay, now the mini here has this, but ignore this. This is gonna be a notes page because we couldn't fit that many in each week. It'd be four more pages times 12 months. It'd be like 50 more sheets, so I couldn't do that. So I made this a notes page next to the monthly budget. Here in the big book, you have the credit card spend, and then you have the monthly budget next to it. The big planner has the month, and the little one does not. Other than that, it is the same. You get the same amount of breakdown paychecks and expense trackers as you do in the mini and the large. They're the same amount of paycheck planners. So if you're paid weekly, bi-weekly, whatever, you're gonna have the same. So the paycheck planner in the big one has a little quote and some grays and stuff, but this is the same. We noticed we're missing one line in the big one. The little one is totally fine. But this one is the exact same layout. It's just has a little gray and that. And then the one big difference is next to the paycheck planner, the expense tracker and the actual spiral. In the mini, it is the payday things as the breakdown of teller, spending by category. Spending by category, you get three of those plus the transaction log, and then it starts again. So the mini has everything in it. So one paycheck looks like this. Plus this, and then it starts again. So that's the only difference. And then the end of the monthly reflections is these lines, and this is a box. But yeah, I hope this helps you guys see what is the difference between the planners. In my opinion, it is very not a big deal. If you love this one, you're gonna love this one. You just don't get the dedicated scripture on the monthly intentions page and the paycheck planners, you actually get a few extra sheets that's not in the big book because it just didn't fit. But you guys can pre-order this October 15th at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. Again, we're gonna have all of the covers I showed you plus the vegan black leather that I've been showing here on YouTube. I hope to see you guys soon, and I'll talk to you next time.